माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी के नेतृत्व में और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के प्रति आस्था रखते हुए विकास को रफ्तार देने के लिए चर्चित सांसद माननीय रौनीत सिंह बिट्टू जी को माननीय विनोद तावरे जी सर्वप्रथम पार्टी की सदस्यता ग्रहण कराएंगे, तत्पश्चात आगे हम बस यही है। आज के इस प्रतिनिधिमंडल का नेतृत्व माननीय विनोद तावरे जी, केंद्रीय रेल आईटी मिनिस्टर,
दोनों साथ में
माननीय अश्विन वैष्णव जी, माननीय ओम पाठक जी थे। तो सर्वप्रथम आज सदस्यता ग्रहण करने वाले माननीय बिट्टू जी का पार्टी की ओर से माननीय राष्ट्रीय महामंत्री महोदय अभिवादन करेंगे और तत्पश्चात अपने विषय को रखेंगे माननीय विनोद तावड़े जी।
भारतीय जनता पार्टी के सह प्रवक्ता श्री संजय मयू जी, ओम पाठक जी और आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में विकसित भारत का संकल्प जो आगे ले जाना है, उस यात्रा में जुड़े श्रीमान रौनीत सिंह बिट्टू जी। जैसे कि हम जानते हैं कि रौनीत सिंह जी ये पंजाब के पूर्व मुख्यमंत्री बेअंत सिंह जी के ग्रैंडसन हैं। पहली बार आनंदपुर से सांसद बने, फिर 14 में लुधियाना से सांसद बने और बीच में जब अधीर रंजन चौधरी बंगाल चुनाव में गए उस समय कांग्रेस पार्टी के मुखिया भी मार्च से जुलाई तक उन्होंने वो जिम्मेवारी निभाई है। मेरा मानना है कि रौनीत जी का पार्टी के साथ जुड़ना पंजाब में भारतीय जनता पार्टी को और मजबूत करने में उनका योगदान रहेगा और आज के निर्णय के बाद रौनीत सिंह जैसे व्यक्तिमत्व का पंजाब भाजपा, पंजाब की जनता इसके प्रति और दायित्व बढ़ता है और वो बहुत खूबी से वो निभाएंगे, ये मुझे विश्वास है। रौनीत जी के संबोधन के पहले मैं चुनाव आयोग में जो आज हमारा प्रतिनिधिमंडल गया था, अश्विनी वैष्णव जी थे, ओम पाठक जी थे, सह मीडिया प्रमुख हमारे संजय मयू जी थे। आज हमने चुनाव आयोग को जो बातें आग्रह से कही है, ये जो विपक्ष का घमंडिया इंडी गठबंधन है, ये तीन लक्ष्य को लेकर चुनाव लड़ने जा रहा है। एक तो देश के प्रधानमंत्री माननीय नरेंद्र मोदी जी को गाली देना, नारी शक्ति का अपमान करना और देश की संस्कृति का अपमानित करते रहना, ये तीन बातों को लेकर विपक्ष लगातार अपने वक्तव्य कर रहा है। और एक बात आग्रह से जो हमने चुनाव आयोग को यह कही कि हर प्रदेश के
As you can see on your screens, Ravneet Singh Bittu over there joining from the Congress, the BJP. Payal, let me just tell our audiences, Ravneet Singh Bittu is someone who's won the Ludhiana seat two times in a row and nail-biting finishes. Other big parties there, obviously the Aam Aadmi Party is a party that at one point was doing very well. In the election that he retained his seat, they obviously got a fourth finish. There's obviously the BJP there too. He's joined over into the BJP. The BJP has not announced a candidate yet from the Ludhiana seat, if that's correct, Payal. Just tell us more here.
The BJP has not announced any of its candidates from Punjab because they were trying to get that conversation going with the Akali Dal. And one of the flag points of not having the alliance was that the BJP was insisting on Ludhiana and Anandpur Sahib. And Ludhiana is, of course, where Ravneet Singh Bittu is a second-time MP. We are not really surprised to see Bittu coming and jumping over because we've seen Bittu hobnob a lot with the BJP leaders in Parliament, especially the top leaders of the BJP. BJP, but continuing to maintain that he does not want to join the party. But you know, when you look at the situation in Punjab, with the Aam Aadmi Party probably looking very uncertain, with the Congress crumbling, and with Akali Dal having nothing to really showcase except for the first family itself, probably Bittu thinks in his own wisdom that this is the best party to be in. Because remember, Ravneet Singh Bittu's family has a history of, you know, laying down their lives for the state as well. His grandfather was Bayan Singh. He's somebody who identified with Punjab as well. And that's the reason he's often spoken about the issue of national security being a critical issue as far as the border state of Punjab is really concerned. I am personally not really surprised to see Ravneet Singh Bittu really jump ship. And he probably would be asked to contest from Ludhiana itself. And Anandpur Sahib is another seat that the BJP was trying to negotiate. Mm. And the sitting member of parliament there is Manish Tiwari.
So a possible hat-trick then for Ravneet Singh Bittu if he is fielded?
Well, obviously, because the BJP does not have a very strong hold as far as the state of Punjab is really concerned. Apart from Gurdaspur, they won one other seat. Of course, the Gurdaspur candidate is not going to get repeated, so the search is going to be there for that. But the BJP is trying to get its foothold in Punjab, and like we were reporting also to Radio, the BJP feels that with the Aam Aadmi Party in a disarray, with the Congress Party looking crumbling, and of course with the Akali Dal actually looking like a spent force, probably they can make inroads. And Bittu is somebody who's won the seat twice, even though it was a very, very hard, you know, it was a hard-fought election. But he is a sitting member of Parliament. He is a Sikh. He is somebody who represents the state. So that's the kind of leadership that the BJP essentially will be looking at. Sunil Jakhat, being from the Congress, must have played an important role in bringing his former party colleague on board over here as well.
And how the BJP can redefine what they mean in Punjab with this is obviously going to be interesting to look at. Payal, thank you. We're going to head into a quick break. On the other side, more of the country's top stories. This is The Nation at 5.